control and coordination. In the previous classes, we have discussed about the forebrain in detail. So in forebrain, we have seen many different categorization, like first one is the olfactory lobes we have seen, then we have seen about the cerebrum, which is called as the seat of intelligence, and then we have discussed about the diencephalon also. Right, here now let us discuss with the next part of the brain, that is called as mesencephalon or midbrain. Okay, so before entering into the midbrain, let us discuss about a small part which is present in the forebrain. Right, in the diencephalon of the forebrain, there is a small system which is the it is not a separate system. The small system associated with some general functions, some important functions also, right? So that system is called as the paleomammalian cortex, or it is also called as the limbic system, right? So limbic system, which is also called as paleomammalian cortex. So where is this limbic system located? This limbic system is located in the thalamus part of the brain, just beneath the temporal lobe. Dear children, so beneath the temporal lobe, there is a limbic system which is present in the thalamus part of the brain. So what is that? When you feel sad, you cry. When you are tensed towards something, you just get fear. Or if you are disturbed with a situation, you start shouting, you start yelling at someone. Right, so this happens because of this limbic system only. So after a long time, you are meeting your friend who you have never met for the past 10 years. You recognize the name of the friend. Hi, how are you? When you speak like that, it is the long-term memory which is being present in your brain, and that is under the control of this limbic system. So the limbic system is said to be the very important system which is very useful to convert the short-term memories to the long-term memories, as well as it is very, very useful to control your emotions, okay? All your emotions are being controlled by this limbic system. So, where does the limbic system present? This limbic system is present in the thalamus part of the brain. So, if we are talking about the limbic system, this limbic system includes two major parts. Okay, so two major parts are seen in the limbic system. The first part, here you can see the spot. So the thalamus part, you could see some spherical structure, and that spherical structure is called as amygdala, right? So in the thalamus, you are observing the spherical structure which is called as amygdala, which is controlling your emotions, your anger, your fear, even your sexual arousal, right? So even your sexual behavior is also being controlled by this amygdala. Then coming to the hippocampus. Hippocampus is the part which extends. It is a tail part from the spherical structure. The extension of the spherical structure is a tail shaped part which is called as the hippocampus. This hippocampus converts the short term memory to the long term memory. Right? This hippocampus helps in the conversion of the short term memory to the long term memory. So when you are meeting an old friend, and if you are able to identify your friend, you remember that your hippocampus is doing its job perfectly. And many scientists have performed some experiments over the animals, removing just the amygdala part. Okay, so removing the amygdala part of the brain of some mammals, those species, those animals, they do not have any sort of reactions. They were calm and quiet. They did not get fear. They did not get anger. And whatever it is. So it did not, it was staying in the cool position, right? So this amygdala is controlling the emotion, which is being scientifically proven by some scientists, right? Then coming to the next part of the brain, that is called as the midbrain. So midbrain is also called as mesencephalon, right? So midbrain is also called as mesencephalon. So coming to the midbrain, so this midbrain, it is majorly divided into two parts. Okay, so midbrain is divided into two parts. What are they? The first part is called as the optic lobes, and then the second part is called as the cerebral peduncles. Okay, so the cerebral peduncles can also be termed as crura cerebri. Right, so cerebral peduncles can also be called as crura cerebri. Right, so coming to these lobes, the midbrain consists of four lobes. Okay, so if you see here, I have drawn the diagram, but I'll draw again. Right, so this is going to be the first lobe, and in the between the first lobe and the second lobe, we can observe some transverse fissure. Right, so this is going to be the second lobe, this is going to be the third lobe, again the transverse fissure, and we are seeing the fourth lobe. Right, so the upper two lobes are called as superior colliculi. Okay, so superior colliculi, the upper two lobes are called as the superior colliculi, which receives the signal from the optic nerves. Okay, so which receives the signals from the optic nerves, and it controls the visual reflex. Okay, it controls the visual reflex. So coming to the midbrain has the four parts. So the first lobe and the second lobe are divided by a transverse fissure. Likewise, the third lobe and the fourth lobe are again divided with the help of some small transverse fissure. Right. So the upper two lobes are called as superior colliculi, whereas the lower two lobes are called as inferior colliculi, which receives the signals from auditory nerves. Okay, so which receives the signals from the auditory nerves, and it controls the hearing impact. Okay, so all the data related to the hearing is controlled by the inferior colliculi. So coming to superior colliculi, the superior colliculi receives signals from the optic nerves, and hence it controls the visual reflex. If you are talking about the inferior colliculi, it receives the commands from the optic, auditory fibers, and it supports the mechanism of hearing. Right. And these four lobes, okay, these four lobes, they are together called as corpora quadrigemina. Okay, these four lobes of the midbrain, they are together called as corpora quadrigemina. Right, so coming to the midbrain is of two parts. Their first part is optic lobe, and second part is called as the cerebral peduncles. So the cerebral peduncles are also called as crura cerebri. So coming to the first part, optic lobes, there are four lobes seen in the midbrain. So the two lobes are separated by the transverse fissure. Right, so the upper two lobes are called as superior colliculi, which controls vision, and in lower two lobes are called as inferior colliculi, which controls the signals of hearing. And then if you are talking about the cerebral peduncles, okay, so it is the long longitudinal band like structures. It is elongated and longitudinal. Okay, so it is elongated and longitudinal nerve fibers. Okay, they are elongated longitudinal nerve fibers. Right, so the main function of this cerebral peduncle, it is connecting the forebrain to the hindbrain. Okay, so forebrain is in the upper part. Hence, the upper part is called as the rostral, and generally this rostral and caudal are the general term which is being given for the upper and the lower. Right. So for upper, rostral forebrain, and it is adjoining the hindbrain. The caudal hindbrain is generally present in the lower part. So it is called as caudal. The forebrain is present in the upper part. Hence they are called as the rostral. Right. So rostral means upper part, whereas the caudal means lower part. It is applied to everything, not only for brain. Right, the upper part is called as rostral and the lowermost part is called as the caudal. So this connects the forebrain and the hindbrain. Okay, the bundle of longitudinal nerve fibers which connects the forebrain and hindbrain is called as the cerebral peduncles or crura cerebri. Hope you are very clear with the midbrain, right? So in the next class, let us take up with the hindbrain. Okay, so we can discuss with the hindbrain in detail.